So, in my virtual circus video, a lot of you mentioned that these types of games are made for the simple purpose of random key sites. If you don't know, sites like G2A sell these packs of about 5 or so random Steam games for usually low prices, with G2A specifically separating them into different rarities. And that's how I came to the idea to buy a couple of these packs and play through the random Steam keys I receive, mainly for the sake of content, but also so that you can see just how big of a scam these things are firsthand. The rarity of the packs literally mean nothing. The games you'll get are all practically the same in terms of gameplay and effort. But gameplay aside, not only did I receive keys for the exact same game twice, but one of these keys didn't even work because it was recycled, meaning it had already been redeemed and yet those assholes still sold it to me. Anyways, I'll go through the smaller and meaningless games first because it's important to see just how big of a waste these packs really are. First off, I cannot believe I have to say this, but 3 of the games I got were from Heyday, the same developer behind Virtual Circus and the same ones that pump out overpriced low effort games. In case you needed any more evidence these games are scams, here you go. The games in question are 3D Puzzled Wild West, World War II, and Wild West again, but this time in top-down view. These all boil down to just pick up a piece, run to place them, go back and pick up another piece, run back to place it, go back, you get the idea. Except for the top-down version, I guess that's a little different because you instead have to find a specific piece on the map, but other than that, it's really just all the same. All the physical objects have no collision whatsoever. You can literally just clip right through them, showing further just how little effort there was put in here. No more needs to be said, really. I wouldn't be surprised if it came out that all these games were AI generated. The next game here, I'm pretty sure, are all mobile games that were ported to PC. Take Battle Ram, for example, a game where you play as a ram that rams into these little robots until they explode. And that's basically just it. You keep doing this for multiple waves until you eventually get bored. But I want you to guess the price of this game on Steam. Alright, time's up. It's $30. 30 whole dollars for this. Another good example of the garbage that riddles the Steam marketplace. And then there's Bomber Crew, which already from the menu alone is pretty buggy. Other than the menu though, the game isn't even that bad, at least for a mobile game. You play as these little army men as you bomb enemy territory, I presume, and resist against attacks, while also upgrading and fixing your plane, and basically just recruiting new members. You're basically running your own military academy here. See, this is a game I'd actually play while lying on my bed trying to fall asleep, but instead it's being sold on Steam for 20 whole dollars, though I guess this one has at least more effort put into it than Battle Ram. Same goes for this other game, Deployment, a game where all you do is fight enemies while taking control of certain points for an advantage. This game is at least priced at $1, but on sale. Normally it would cost $10. $10 for 2 game modes, ay ay ay. I'm not even going to talk about this thing. Anyways, these mobile games get a nice 5 Nokia phones out of 10, simply because I would actually play some of them regularly, just not on my PC. Before we get into the games that feel like at least more than 20 minutes were put into them, I want to give one specific game its own category, Eden Create World. See, this game has it all. Character customization, that's it. Because once you create your character and load in, this is all you get. A test demo world from Unreal Engine, with amazing features such as spawners that don't actually work, floor placements, and the lack of bugs. I couldn't even do what was promised in the store page's images. I am just in awe at what I'm seeing here. I cannot believe a game like this exists. See, Heyday games at least have some type of gameplay, albeit really fucking boring, but this game literally has nothing. And they're selling it for $10? Outrageous. Eden Create World alone gets a divided by 0 out of 10. I'd have more fun washing my money flush down the toilet than playing this thing. Now we can move on to Battle vs. Chess, which is actually the game I got 2 keys for. So if anyone wants to own this game for whatever reason, here you go. But I wouldn't be surprised if this key has already been recycled to another buyer by now. If you're familiar with Harry Potter, you may remember that scene where Ron and Harry were playing Wizard's Chess. That's basically what this entire game is. Chess, but with some battle animations every time a piece is eaten. There is a semblance of a story here, but I can't be asked to remember it since it's just all told through text. All I really know is that we're the White King and the Black King is our enemy, but also our cousin. Each level adds a bit of uniqueness to the game to make it a little more fresh. For example, in this level, every piece that captures changes color, forcing you to actually sacrifice your pieces as opposed to eating. Other than that though, there isn't really much else to talk about. It's literally just chess, which wasn't bad for me as I actually like chess, but if I didn't, this game would have been much, much more boring. I'd give Battle vs. Chess a nice 6 pawns out of 10, something I might play whenever I have nothing else better to do. Next, we have Bike Out, which is literally just a biking course made out of pre-made assets. At least aligning the pieces, I'm sure, took some time, though there are sections where the pieces aren't even placed properly. The game is actually slightly cool until you try to do any sort of trick whatsoever, since if you aren't facing straight, you'll just die. Doesn't matter how fast or slow you fall, looking in the wrong direction will just have you plop on the ground. This honestly feels a lot like that bike obby on Roblox, with most of the fun stemming from finding shortcuts and ways to cheese the game. Oh my god! How far down? What the fuck? I'm not doing all that. Okay, ready? Wah! Oh! Fuck me, dude. I didn't see that. What the fuck? I only got as far as this big ass town because I just could not, for the love of God, find the ending. It's set up as this humongous maze with absolutely zero indicators on which way to go, with paths that lead on forever just to reach a dead end. And anytime I tried to think outside of the box, I just died. So Bike Out gets a nice 2 dirt bikes out of 10 from me. Maybe someday I'll go back and try to finish it, but definitely not anytime soon. The next game, Dungeons of Elements, is only funny because of the effects it had on me in the real world. This game initially faked me out because they allowed me to design my own character and even give them a little story for role-playing purposes. And after a quick little prologue, they launched me straight into battle. That. Huh. What? Yeah, this is the entire game. There are no words to describe the disappointment I felt upon seeing this. I went to sleep that night and ended up actually dreaming about this game, but in my dream, it looked more like Redguard with wizards and whatnot. So when I woke up, I excitedly logged back on to play this game again and was hit with that same level of disappointment a second time. I've never been disappointed twice by the exact same game. Oh my god. Anyways, Dungeons of Elements gets 1 wizard out of 10 for playing with my time and feelings, and also for just being another Candy Crush clone. This next game, The Last Room, is kind of in the same line as Battle vs. Chess, where I don't think it's a bad game as long as you're a fan of the genre. It's basically just your average escape room experience, all of course made with pre-made assets. I don't know, to me it's kind of fun to figure out how to escape rooms, though none of the levels are really even that hard. But I don't think any price justifies the purchase of this specific game, because as of writing this, it is literally unbeatable. There's a bug in the third level that doesn't allow for this door to open. And if it doesn't open, you can't press the play and finish the level. So I'll have to give the game 2 skulls out of 10 until I'm actually able to beat it. The last game on this list kind of had a little bit of potential in my opinion, though it was all wasted pretty quickly. Nightwalker is a game where you play the role of a private investigator whose car breaks down, leaving you stranded in the woods, forcing you to traverse the woods and find some jumper cables. However, you quickly find that monsters roam these woods, which you can only kill by leading them into a pit. Pretty generic and simple, but a good game doesn't need to reinvent the wheel or anything. The problem is that this game quickly becomes a walking simulator, with the occasional running with monsters, kind of like Virtual Circus, though at least a little more enjoyable. It sometimes feels like the developers tried their very best to find any way to waste the gamer's time so that you can't refund it. Because other than just walking around the woods and to this building, before you can go in, you're forced to find and kill 3 monsters around the map. And once inside, there's another monster you have to avoid as you just search for fuses to restore power and then look for ropes to move this metal box blocking the jumper cables. This is actually the only game I was able to 100% finish, because after you find the cables and exit out the building, the game literally just ends. That was it. And they want me to buy its sequel. Yeah, I don't think so. Forget the sale. You pay $40 for a game you can complete in about 20 minutes? Dear God, I don't care about Steam's refund policy or these key packs. No game should cost this much for such little gameplay. At least I could have gotten Virtual Circus for $3. Though I ended up not. Nightwalker gets 1 Skinwalker out of 10, somehow the worst and yet best horror game I've ever played. I really haven't played that many. Anyways, that's about all the games I have for you today. If you're still thinking about buying these packs even after watching this video, then by all means, go ahead. I'm not going to hold you back. But don't be surprised if the games you get either don't work or are just complete nothing burgers. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, subscribe and ciao.